Hi, I'm Radek, I'm a developer advocate at Ceramic, and I will show you how to get started building quickly with ComposeDB on Ceramic. So here's what you will accomplish in the next few minutes. You will configure your local environment, run a local Ceramic node, operate a fully functional dApp on your local machine, and learn the next steps to continue building on Ceramic. If you prefer a written form, or if you just want to easily copy and paste all the commands, you can read an article on the Ceramic blog. The link to the article and to everything else that you might need is in the video description below. Ready? Let's go! Let's get started with setting up our environment. We need to make sure that we have a couple of things installed in our system before we can move forward. And the first thing is to make sure that we have Node.js installed with at least version 16. We can check the version of Node.js by node-v. Then the next thing that we need to install is jq, a lightweight command line JSON processor. If you are on a Mac, you can install it by brew install jq. So let's create a directory ceramic. The next thing we want to do is to run a local ceramic node on our system. The easiest way to configure and run a ceramic node is through Wheel. Wheel is a CLI tool to help you run a ceramic node. You can install it by running a command like this, which is in the article that I mentioned at the beginning. You can go and copy and paste it. The link is in the description. So we are installing the Wheel. Wheel is now ready to go. We run the wheel command by typing /wheel. Now we have to go through a list of different options. The default configuration will run your ceramic node in memory, or you can also run a dev on clay, which is a testnet, or on mainnet. If you run it in memory, your app data will be stored locally on your machine, and it's a great way to start engaging with ComposeDB without additional hassle of configuring more options if you want to go to testnet or mainnet, which would be the next steps after playing with your local dApp. And the next is the project name, Ceramic Test App. Let's have it as a default. Path is default as well. Do I want to include Ceramic? Yes, I do. Do we want to include ComposeDB? Absolutely, we do. Do we want to create a sample application? Yes, we do. This is what we will be reviewing here today. The next step is admin DID configuration. DID is decentralized identifier. We can generate it and along with a private key or input from file. We don't have a file, so we need to generate it. The default path is good enough. Will config file location default is good enough. Everything else, defaults are good. So now we have configured what we wanted to configure, and now we are waiting for Wheel to do its magic, and then we can start our app locally. This step took about 2 minutes, and Wheel installed all the dependencies, and now it's asking if I would like Ceramic to be started as a daemon, and I do. And this will launch a local Ceramic node on my computer with an example app for me to play with. And after another couple of minutes, we are getting to this stage, and you will know that everything is up and running smoothly. If you see the following output in your terminal, it says what you need to do next to launch your application. So you need to go to this directory and then run this command to launch your app. But we need to keep this terminal window open because this will be running our Ceramic node. So we need to do everything else in a new window. And this is a new one where I will be running all the other commands. So first I need to go to this directory. In my new terminal window, I'm here. And next I need to actually launch the app. It launch the app, and this terminal window again needs to be left open because it's running the app right now, and we need to open another terminal window if we want to do anything else with code or commands, because this one is running our app. Let's have a look at it. So this is how the app looks, the default state. First thing that we need to do is we need to authenticate, and we can do it either with key DID, which we created in the process of building the app, or we can log in with Ethereum DID PKH, which is a fancy expression for login with MetaMask. So let's authenticate with key DID, which is automatic because we already have it in the system. This is a simple social app where you can create a profile, post updates, explore other users' posts or follow them. And that's just a simple app to start playing with. So the first thing that we need to do is to create a profile. Name, Radek, username. I want to be creative here. Description, that's me. Gender, male. And emoji, I'll choose a shark. Profile updated. So now we have our profile. Let's go home and create our first post. What's up, docs? Created post, and we already see it in the timeline. Let's create another one. It's getting hot in here. And let's share this one as well. And now we have two posts from myself. Wouldn't be a great social app if only I would be able to create posts. So let's try and create another profile and see how it looks from both ways. For this, let's launch an incognito localhost 3000 and now authenticate in a different way with MetaMask. Sign in. And now we are a different user now. But we are seeing the posts which have already been created. Now let's update our own profile. Let's be a dolphin now. Update profile. Profile updated. So now we are on a home screen on the feed screen, and we can start creating our own posts. Hello, water world, because I'm a dolphin. Done. And now, as you can see, it's from a different user, a different profile. Our timeline is being updated. Now that you see how it works from the outside, let's have a look at the inside, how it looks in the code. What's great about this app is that you can see everything. You can see all of the implementation, all the data models, all the front-end components. To start digging deeper, you need to go to the app directory that we created. The interesting stuff is going on in the composites directory. Here you'll see all the data models used by the application, defined using the GraphQL schema definition language. And the first one is the profile. We started with creating a profile, and this is the model of basic profile. This model creates a GraphQL implementation of a fundamental user profile data model, and it describes everything that we have seen in the app. The name, the username, description, gender sets the rules for the name, the type of the field, the minimum, maximum length, and everything else. So you can either create the model from scratch, or if you know and want to use an existing model, you can use that model by ID. So we have started with the model, and then what we did next, we created a post. So this is how the post data model looks like. And it also describes a relation to the basic profile model in here. So first of all, it shows the relation to basic profile, and that is the field, how it is related. And the rest is describing the posts, the model itself. Now, the next data model is establishing the relation between basic profile and the post model. It shows the posts and the basic profile, how they are related, and this is how everything fits together. And the last one is the following, that you can start following somebody and then it will be showing you up in your feed, profile ID, the profile, and how it relates to basic profile. In addition to data models, you can explore the pages, and this directory contains the pages that you see, the front end, when you interact with the application. And in these pages, you can see some examples of how GraphQL queries are used to retrieve and display the information that you see on the page. So for example, if you go to explore DSX, and explore shows you some posts, and this is how that query is being constructed. So give me the posts, GraphQL, from that node, give me the ID, the body, the created, and the profile. And for that profile, give me ID name, username, and emoji. So basically, this is the query that then you have all the data in your app, and you can display all those posts, specifically here, the last 300, and you have all the data inside of that query where it has all the content and also all the information on the profiles. As you start playing with the app more and more, and you start creating more and more data in the app, you can start interacting with this data and getting queries and showing the data locally by running a GraphQL server and running GraphQL queries against your own local data on your computer. The way to do it is to run this command, which will generate the composite, compiling the composite done. And after that, we can start the GraphQL server, PostDB GraphQL server. So now the GraphQL server is listening, and let's go and see how it looks. Let's run the query. We can ask our basic profile index and to get all the nodes, the names and descriptions of our first two basic profiles created. That was a shark and a dolphin. And let's run it. And this is the data that we get back from our local node. And we can get as much or as little as we want. Like, for example, if we want to also show emoji, we can add gender as well because we had that. And that's how we can interact with the app, with the data, to see what is available in your application. And there you have it. You now have a fully functional dApp running on your local machine, have everything configured, you're running ComposeDB on your machine, and you can query the data, you can interact with your app, and you can start building on top of that. So congratulations are in order. You've done it. Now what next? Next, you can consider a few steps. The first one would be to dive into ComposeDB documentation. If you go to Ceramic, you go to build ComposeDB, and here you can dive into docs. The first one is to set up your environment. There's a lot of good stuff in docs here, but also make sure to have a look at the guides section. The guides are a little bit more comprehensive, and there's a lot of good stuff in the guides. Second, you can interact with the data by constructing more advanced GraphQL queries, or even update the existing record by executing a mutation. That could be step number two. Step number three could be going from local to a testnet, a clay testnet, as we call it, which will connect your node to Ceramic Anchor Service and create commits on blockchain. For testnet, the commits will be on Ethereum testnet. For mainnet, it will be on Ethereum mainnet. And you can easily do it with a test app by just choosing a clay testnet instead of in-memory option at step one. And then you can start playing and improving the application itself that we have just built. introduce a new feature or use it as a foundation of your own unique project. For example, in the app that we have right now, in our mini social app, we can introduce a like feature. We can introduce a comment feature, which are both missing right now. For that, you would need to create new models and think of how they interact with each other. Or you can introduce more sophisticated queries to filter the posts displayed on your feed. And after that, it's whatever your heart desires. And if you run into any problems, or you have some questions, or you want to share your project with us, you can head to our community forum. You can find our community forum right here. There are a lot of questions there. There are even more answers to those questions. People are interacting, people are building and learning from each other. So happy building and see you soon.